This movie is about a band of seven friends who are outsiders, who are getting bullied. They're on summer vacation, getting bullied. And in addition to getting bullied, they are also being chased down by this crazy maniacal clown trying to kill them. Starring Bill Skarsgard, who is playing Pennywise, Jaeden Lieberher, Jeremy Ray Taylor, Sophia Lillis, Finn Wolfhard, Chosen Jacob, Jack Dylan Grazer, Wyatt Oleff, and Nicholas Hamilton. I was excited going into this movie, and I started buying into the preview. Maybe it's scarier than I first thought. A whole new generation of children and people will be terrified of clowns. I'm gonna say this off the bat, the backing. Because overall, the acting was very, very good for these children. Maybe one or two scenes, the music took me out of the scene. But for the most part, the music was chosen well for this movie. The plot, it works well. The movie runs a little long. It's 2 hours and 15 minutes long. It's just kind of like a teenage fun film, like Ferris Bueller's Day Off or something. They're just having fun or doing teenage stuff or being bullied, and it's not, there's no sign of Pennywise. Then all of a sudden he pops back in and he's like, whoa, what the fuck? It's kind of jarring, like the way it's cut and spliced together like that. It's like, oh, we're in a regular movie. I done forgot we're even in a horror movie. And boom, there goes Pennywise. It was a little strange. Some people are going to find this movie extremely scary. This movie is rated R. F-bombs galore, no nudity, but lots and lots of F-bombs and adult jokes. The movie was actually more funny than scary, intentionally. And it really felt like an 80s movie. Like, it didn't feel like a modern movie. And I liked the way they did that. It really felt like an 80s movie and felt true to the source. And that's kind of what made the long length work. Pennywise is creepy as hell still. Bill Skarsgård does an excellent job portraying Pennywise. And a thing that I really enjoyed about this movie is there are not a lot of CGI graphics that they depend on to carry the horror or the scares. It's camera tricks and acting. And that actually makes it more scary because it makes it more real. You're traveling and growing with the children throughout this movie, and when you see the movie, hopefully you understand what I'm saying, because I'm trying to say this without giving away too much of the movie. Even though it's based off the TV series and a book that's been out for a long time, I'm still trying not to spoil it for those who have never seen or read that. You kind of follow the progression of the children with their experiences with Pennywise till the very end, and you feel the same way they feel. And you've seen Pennywise in the previews, you've seen his face and everything, and I like how they did that, because a lot of horror movies now, they kind of depend on the, we won't show you the antagonist, the scary thing, until the third act. Whereas this showed you Pennywise literally within the first 10 minutes. I think that was a very intelligent decision, which goes back to the one, once again, the source material, because that image is seared into your mind. And while this movie for me wasn't really scary while I was watching the movie, I think I jumped 3, maybe 4 times. I laughed loads of times. But 3 or 4 times for 2 hours, it's not a lot. But when I left the theater, the images were stuck in my head. I think that's where Stephen King really thrives. He knows how to write and create images in your head that stick. Overall, though, the movie was a little lackluster. Yeah, I think it's the way that the story was told, and that it was just, while there was cohesion in the story, of course, it seemed a little sporadic. It was like, okay, I'm a regular teenage movie, now I'm a horror film. Now I'm a teenage drama, now I'm a horror film. Now I'm a comedy, now I'm a horror film. The original TV series wasn't really that funny. It focused more on horror, but they put a lot of comedy in this movie. So positives: Pennywise the clown, the children acting, the horror aspects of the movie. And they did make me feel for the characters. I was really feeling for all these children. The adults, not so much, but the children, they created an environment for them to become close friends and become close friends with you. Negatives: the musical score for me just was off sometimes. The movie just kind of didn't have a true identity of a horror film. Part one of the original just flowed better than the 2017 remake. I give this movie but that's just my opinion. you can go see the movie. And you'll float too! So when I left the theater, I am seeing, like, in my mind's eye, red balloons just everywhere, floating everywhere. I'm getting creeped out, it's dark as hell. Motherfuckers, y'all got me! I'm scared! Even though I wasn't scared in the movie, I think it's more telling that I was scared outside of the movie.